dollar bill, yo. What's up, guys? Got some more Crowfall action for you today. In this video, I'm going to be talking about things I would like to see changed in terms of class balance and general mechanics. For the most part, I think Crowfall is very well balanced with how many combinations there are. With all the stuff you can make, there's really only two definitively overpowered things in the game right now, and that is Pitfighter Champions and Sanctifier Tank Confessors. Those are the only two things that I would say just flat out in every situation are just OP. Now, you might be looking at this footage seeing me just own people on the Assassin, but the Assassin, that's its niche. The niche of the assassin is getting people in these small engagements. And if you go and talk to some of the more experienced players in Crowfall, none of them are talking about assassins being overpowered. That is not even on the radar in terms of big team fights or guild fights or anything like that. The assassin is a niche role. It's for that 1v1 gank in the forest. That's what the assassin is very good at. And a lot of the classes are like that. Some of these, like the duelist, for example, can hit stupidly hard. The duelist can hit for like 5k, but you don't see him in team fights. You don't see him in keep fights. So they've done a very good job at making the classes pretty well balanced while also filling a niche. You know, not to shit on World of Warcraft, but, you know, they've homogenized the hell out of the classes in that game, and they're still really not that balanced. I mean, take a look at, you know, Mop Warriors back then. Like, holy shit, man. So, yeah, there's some definitely some things that are absurdly OP right now in Crowfall, with Pitfighter Champions in particular. But all things considered, this early, pretty damn good. So, number one change I'd like to see made, obviously, Pitfighter Champion survivability is just crazy. Like, that is insane, and they also can do pretty damn good damage with pretty good CC. I think that I almost don't even have a suggestion for what they need to do to pit fighters, because I think it's just going to happen. They're probably just going to make those ultimates charge up way slower and probably heal less. So I'm not worried about pit fighters not getting nerfed. They didn't get nerfed in this most recent patch, but they also didn't do any serious balance changes. So, Pit Fighter's definitely going to get nerfed. Now onto the Sanctifier Confessor, and they've actually implemented one of my ideas into the balancing already. It just hasn't been patched in yet. But right now, Confessors can use full range with the Sanctifier tree, and I suggested that be forced. And they are actually going to be doing that, but it just has not been patched in yet. So in the future, all Sanctifier Confessors will have the 8-meter range forced upon them. Now, if you are somebody that is playing the Sanctifier Confessor in the proper way right now with that passive slotted, you're actually going to be getting a little bit of a buff because they're baking that in. It's not going to be a passive, it's just going to be something that you have, so you'll have another passive to work with. So, kudos to you guys that have been playing it, you know, the real way, or the intended way, I should say, because you will actually be getting a buff. Now, there's some more things that I think the Confessor kit in general needs to change. The knockups on tornadoes, I think, need to have a diminishing return. They don't, or if they do, it is non-existent. Like, I just don't think they do. I haven't tested that personally, but holy shit, the knockups in this game are just insane. And I think that it's a little problematic that the Confessor, their most powerful weapon is fall damage. I think that's just not the greatest design. I think it disproportionately punishes tanks, and I am a Myrmidon player, so maybe I'm a little bit biased because the knockups really fuck me up, and I'm also a tank. But I think it's just silly. I would rather Confessors just do more damage with their other attacks and not have fall damage be the most lethal thing, because right now it's almost a shit shoot whether you get one shot or not. If you're trying to push up at an enemy on a hill, it's just impossible with these tornadoes. So there just ends up being stalemates where nobody wants to walk up the hill because they'll get one shot by the tornado spam. So I think a lot of this is probably going to get fixed with the physics update that they're doing. They're doing some stuff with the character controller and updating the physics and making them, from what I can understand, a less extreme. There's going to be less of it. So maybe that will fix the one shot issue. But if it doesn't, I think that the physics in general, there just needs to be less of them, less pushing, less pulling, less shooting up in the air. I think that fall damage being the most lethal thing in the game is just silly. And again, I'm a Myrmidon, I'm biased, But I think a lot of other people would probably agree that it's just dumb when the amount of damage you can take from fall damage from a tornado just out of sheer RNG, whether it shoots you to the sky or whether it doesn't, it's just, it's basically random. And a perfect example of why having your kit tuned around fall damage is bullshit is the Myrmidon, for example. So I can have 10,000 health, 100% HP. I pop my Myrmidon stuff, I shoot up to 20,000 max HP, but I'm at 50%. Then I get knocked up by a tornado and die, because fall damage is based off of a percentage of your maximum health. So me using my Myrmidon abilities actually screwed me over and caused me to die due to the way fall damage is calculated. So I would definitely like to see the physics less, or maybe you don't, I don't know. I just really dislike that mechanic. I don't know how they could really just nerf fall damage across the board. I don't think anybody would cry about stepping off of a cliff and not taking fall damage. So maybe make that threshold a little bit higher on fall damage, and that would be a decent way to fix it. Also, with the way confessors are with the tornadoes, again with the DRs, you can't have too many of them. They are an extremely popular class right now in big fights and in small fights. They're just one of the best classes in the game. You can't have too many of them. Nobody ever said, "Wow, we got too many confessors spamming tornadoes." They're just sick. And they're also very good in the current environment in big fights, because it gets the optimization isn't great in the big fights right now, so they're laggy, which makes the tornadoes even better, and that makes the physics do even more crazy shit and one-shot you. So, yeah. Next thing. I'm done with the confessor rant. Retaliates need to be more costly. Right now, any non-physics-based CC is almost useless. Knockdowns, stuns, they're pretty useless, because you always have a retaliate for them, and in return, that makes the CC specs pretty bad. Vandal, for example, the Vandal assassin that's focused on CC, it's terrible. It's so hard to play it right to begin with, and people just retaliate at everything you do. So, and all of that is just due to the fact that you have a ton of, you have two retaliates, then you have the CC immunity stuff, then you have the ultimates, and every time you retaliate, you're also CC immune for a few seconds, and you've got two of those, and then when you don't have that, you've got your ultimate, and then a lot of people run Juggernaut. It's crazy. There's too many CC, I don't think there's too many CC breaks. It's just, I think retaliate needs to cost like 75% of your stamina. I think retaliate needs to be way more costly than it is right now, because it's killing a lot of the CC specs, and it's killing a lot of the setup. You can't really set up a CC chain on somebody, and that's a really rewarding thing to do. I know when you're the guy getting CC'd, it's not fun, but right now in its current iteration, it's useless. Anything that's not physics-based, anything that's not a push, pull, or knock-up, it's really not that effective. So I would like to see that changed. And another thing on the balance, I think the disciplines are very well balanced in terms of stealth versus anti-stealth. Right now, I think anti-stealth is probably a little bit too powerful, not because of the actual disciplines, but because of the way you can switch the disciplines in and out. That's not going to be a thing anymore. And for the most part, I think all of the disciplines are fairly well balanced. Like, there's not anything that is stupidly overpowered, but there's a lot of stuff that's dog shit. So, which I think is not the worst thing in the world. Like, it sucks when there's a few things that you just absolutely have to run. Right now, there's kind of like an S tier of like the sickest disciplines, and then there's kind of some crap below it. So some of them need to get buffed up a little bit, but there's nothing that needs to get patched right away, luckily. So this is something I'm excited for, though, because right now the game has sort of been an echo chamber, where the same group, the same few hundred people have been testing the shit out of the game. And it's the same ideas. It's the same people, the same mindsets, coming up with the same solutions. And I think once we get some more people in here, some new, different people with brand new ways of thinking, they're going to expose some stuff that has been sitting right under our nose the whole time that is amazing, that's going to just blow the rails off of, it's going to blow the windows out of this building. So I'm very excited to get some new people in here, some fresh blood. So anyway, that's my rant. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you're interested in Crowfall, be sure to sign up with the referral link down in the description. If you sign up with that link, you get 5% off, as well as getting into the beta for free. You can still sign up to get in the beta for free. There will be no open beta. So sign up, get your spot in line, even if you're not interested in the game right now, just sign up at least. Because there's not going to be, you're not going to be able to just sign up and get in when it starts. So do that. Also, I have an interview with J. Todd Coleman and Thomas Blair, the creative director and the lead designer, on tomorrow. When you see this video, it will be tomorrow. So it'll be on Thursday at 11 a.m. Central. And that should be streamed on my channel or the Crowfall channel. It's still sort of up in the air, but it'll be on either or. Stay tuned to my Twitter. It'll be live streamed. So, anyway, I think that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. See you next time. Have a good one.